Eastbound and down, loaded up and trucking. Are we gonna do what they say can be done? We've got a long way to go and a short time to get there. I'm eastbound just like no bandit run. Keep your foot hard on the pedal, son, never mind them brakes. Let it all hang out, cause we got a run to make. The boys are thirsty in Atlanta, and there's beer in Texarkana, and we'll bring it back no matter what it takes. Eastbound and down, loaded up and trucking. Are we gonna do what they say can't be done? We've got a long way to go and a short time to get there. I'm eastbound, just watch old bandit run.
Welcome to the Born Stupid Show. What's today's date?
September 9th.
September 9th, 2018. You got Ross here. You got John.
Right here.
You got Mica.
Back in Middle America.
Back in Middle America. Joining us from his undisclosed location in the F-150. So yeah, you guys see that Burt Reynolds died?
Yep.
Yeah, man, old Smokey and the Bandit.
Yep.
I seen just something on Facebook the other day. I think it was your mom posted.
I don't know. I don't follow her on Facebook.
I don't follow her either, but
I don't even see what she posts.
It was a naked picture of Burt Reynolds scrolling across my newsfeed. I'm like, God damn.
Thanks, Mom.
Yeah. Not cool. Not
yeah,
cool.
I hurt her feelings when I told her that I don't follow her on Facebook. I was like, I don't see a single thing you post. Why? Because either you're posting political crap that you have no idea what the hell you're talking about, or you post stupid shit, so.
So I'd rather not see that.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Yeah, he was in a bunch of good movies.
Longest Yard?
Yes, The Longest Yard.
Both times?
He was in the racing movie, Stroker Ace.
Cannonball Run.
I don't know if I've seen that, Stroker Ace.
Dude, it's awesome, man. It's based on NASCAR, Stroker Ace. He was born to race. Charlie Daniels sang a song about it.
I guess we're going to have a movie, a Burt Reynolds night, and just watch all of his movies, get drunk.
He's in Boogie Nights.
Yeah.
Mark Wahlberg.
Boogie Nights,
yeah.
Yep. Yeah, he's a pretty good actor.
I didn't realize it, but he was a college football running back for Florida State University.
Yep.
Really? I didn't know that.
Yeah. Yeah, and he was supposedly pretty good.
Then I think he blew out his knee or something like that. He hurt his knee, and that's when he stopped playing.
Yeah.
Yep, that's what they said about me, too.
It was also interesting. Lee Corso, the guy that puts all the mascot heads on stuff College Game Day, that was his roommate.
That's awesome.
Oh, he'll probably die next.
Don't say that.
I'm just saying. I mean, they're up there. 82, I think
Lee
was.
Lee Corso said that Burt Reynolds, when they were in college, would go down to the bank, and there'd be some hot tellers there, and he'd always come back with at least two of them back to their dorm room and wear them out and send them back to the bank.
Wow.
Like every weekend.
The cash in hand?
Same girls? It had to be the same girls because they're not swapping out bank tellers like that.
I don't know. Bank tellers were probably like flight attendants back in the day, man.
You think? Oh, yeah, they probably had a. That was probably everybody had to go to bank then. Now you don't ever walk into a bank hardly.
I can't tell you the last time I went into a bank.
Yeah, he was probably doing that quite a bit. Yeah, they might have had more people working there than supply and demand, you know.
Yeah, they barely had cars then, let alone drive up windows.
Yeah, so you had to walk in.
They drove their horse and buggy through the drive-thru.
Yeah, but there was ATMs. We found out last week that there were ATMs back then. Not sure how they were using them.
1969.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. Also heard Mac Miller died.
Who?
Yeah.
Who the fuck is that guy?
The other white rappers?
Yep. I've heard a few songs.
Who the fuck is that guy? That was my response when I heard he died. Yeah. I don't know who the fuck that is.
It's like I knew who he was and I've heard some of his stuff.
Who the fuck is that guy?
What'd he die of?
Overdose. Not sure what he OD'd on.
Couldn't get the computer to stop playing that.
Probably smoking heroin or something.
He died of being a white rapper.
Eminem killed him.
Yeah, he committed suicide before Eminem can diss him.
Yeah, he's worried about the Eminem disses. Have y'all been following
Pretty
that any?
Savage.
Nope. Really not what? That great.
John asked if we've been following that whole Eminem diss thing.
Eminem.
My response was nope.
Machine Gun Kelly. I heard the Machine Gun this Kelly thing, but I don't remember if I've heard Eminem's thing.
I haven't heard any of it. I've just seen all the shit on Facebook. People saying, oh, Eminem this, and Machine Gun Kelly this, and blah, 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 blah. Like, whatever.
That's what my brother posted. He was like, he heard that Machine Gun Kelly diss, and he liked it. He's like, man, where do I find Machine Gun Kelly's new cassette? I'm like, in the fucking garbage can next to Eminem's. Because I'm not allowed to listen to Eminem's music anymore. Eminem, I can't listen to his music anymore.
Yeah, you're Trump supporter, huh?
I voted for Donald Trump, so I'm not allowed to listen to his music. So.
Oh, that's sad.
Yeah.
He lost a listener in me. I wouldn't have bought his shit anyway.
I'm just still trying to figure out where Jesse's going to find a cassette at.
Oh, you just make your own. Just dub your own cassettes.
You gonna get your Walkman out?
Hell yeah.
Yep, we got Post Malone almost died again. That's sad.
He just needs to walk
everywhere.
He just
needs to quit
trapping. Yeah.
Yeah.
I saw he posted on Twitter the other day, like, Jesus Christ, God fucking must hate me or something like that. Plane wreck one day, then a car accident the next day.
You think he's got a song coming out for that?
Better now. He's better now.
Yeah. Oh, got an ad. I cut it off before it plays.
Yeah, he posted, God must hate me, LOL, after he got in that car accident.
Between the flight and then
that? Severe car accident, but they said he wasn't hurt.
He's probably going to overdose next, too.
Yep.
Damn it. Yep. We have to do a tribute for him.
Excuse me.
So speaking of weird shit, because he's pretty weird. A woman was caught dipping her chicken fingers into her soda. Did you guys see that?
I saw that. That's fucking nasty.
Into a soda?
Yeah.
She was straight up dipping her chicken finger, eat it. And she was double dipping, I think.
She needs to be put in the mental institution.
Yeah. Locked up.
What were they? Spicy chicken tenders?
It doesn't matter.
Cool them off?
Doesn't matter. I think it was at the U.S. Open, I think.
Unless the primary ingredient in that soda is ranch, she shouldn't be dipping her damn chicken in it.
People are telling me I should go to jail.
Or barbecue sauce.
Can you see her?
It's a little blurry. Not so good through the iPad.
Well, let me show you this. Supposedly, she's pretty hot. I don't know if you can see that.
Oh, okay. Hey, what's up?
Yeah.
I'm missing. Oh, goddamn, yeah.
Yeah, so.
She can dip her chicken tenders in whatever she wants.
They're talking about lock her up in my room.
Yeah.
Can I dip her in a cup of soda?
Yeah, for real. You're like, all right, so I'll take you dipping chicken fingers in your
can
soda.
Can I dip my chicken tender into her?
Yeah.
Do you think there was extra soda in the cup? Or maybe she
it was.
Get like a big cup of barbecue sauce?
It was like one of those giant clear cups.
And the kid sitting next to her was just giving her like the weirdest fucking look.
Yeah.
Like, he was just like, what the fuck are you doing?
Yeah, so apparently like her dad used to do that when she was a kid, so that's why she started doing it. And all that, like, you and your dad are fucking disgusting.
Yeah. Yeah, that shit was funny.
Maybe it softens the chicken tender up, makes it easier to chew.
Well, put your teeth back in if you're going to eat fucking chicken tenders.
Maybe she was out of Super Poly Grip this week.
Yeah. She should just
her ex-boyfriend then knocked her ex-boyfriend then knocked her teeth out.
Because she was dipping her chicken tenders in his fucking soda.
Probably what happened.
She's probably crazy. She's probably crazy as fuck.
That's nasty.
Yep.
Chicken tenders in the soda.
Imagine what she dips her spaghetti in then.
How are you dipping spaghetti?
I don't know. If she's dipping chicken tenders in fucking soda, she might be dipping spaghetti into like a bowl of
a mayonnaise.
Mothball soup.
She's probably she's probably one of those fuckers that sprinkles M&Ms in her spaghetti and you know has sprinkles and fucking weird.
Kind of off topic a little bit. I had a roommate in college. The bitch drank a gallon of milk with everything.
Ugh.
It didn't make a shit Like, he'd be eating spaghetti and he'd be drinking a gallon of milk with it.
Well, it's just like back in like elementary school.
Gallon, every time he drank a gallon at each sitting?
He'd have a whole gallon and he'd drink right out of the gallon. He may not finish the whole thing, but that
the
was
the fact that you're letting that milk get warm because you're sitting out and you're drinking out of it.
And you have your spaghetti lips on the fucking jug of the...
Did y'all share milk? My kid doesn't drink milk.
I don't drink milk. I can't drink milk, man.
Well, it's just like when you're back in elementary school, you think back, you drank chocolate milk or white milk with everything. You think back, you're like, oh, I drank chocolate milk when I ate my pizza.
I still drink milk all the time.
That's true, yeah. The school lunches, yeah, I had strawberry milk.
My Fiestada stop sign pizza was the best.
I guess that ain't so weird now when you put it like that.
Yeah.
You
know, I loved drinking milk for my lunch.
He was just
stuff.
A giant
it's so
kid.
Much better than sodas and stuff like that.
I beg to differ.
No, that shit's bad for
occasionally,
me.
So is milk.
Occasionally, you could get little
better than soda.
Squeeze packets of like orange juice.
See, that's how
it shops. You
just got to think about it. We are the only mammal that sucks the milk out of a teat out of another animal. No other animal drinks another animal's milk, except for us.
Yeah.
Yep.
Because we're the only ones that have the power to do that. If a cow came up to you and said, let me suck your titty, you ain't going to do it.
Hell yeah, would you? That'd be awesome. That'd be good for the show. Bust out your cell phone. Get this on camera.
We got Dirty Dan
jumping
in. No, my two cents.
Don't cats drink milk from a saucer?
Cats have nipples. Can you milk
cats,
them?
Yeah, cats drink milk.
She's right here.
Milk they her. Drink cow's milk.
If you give it to them, though.
Yeah, they don't know.
They wouldn't be drinking that if we didn't give it to them.
Nope.
What are you saying? Your two cents?
On the... chicken and Coke. Ugh. How's that any different than like when you put syrup on chicken and waffles and stuff? It's the same.
Because it's syrup and it's Coke. They're
but
different.
The syrup is in the Coke, like that sweet syrup.
But it's still, it's not as thick. It's not like it's you're basically making a soggy ass chicken tender.
Your syrup is not on ice.
It's like her sauce.
Whatever. No.
You're just as fucking weird.
Yeah. You're going to see her eating chicken tenders.
Except I don't want to lock you in my room. I want you out.
Get out.
Get out. I know you. Leave.
Get out.
For lunch, we're all going to go to McDonald's.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Get their chicken tenders and their Coke. Dip it in.
Leave my Coke alone.
That's hilarious.
That's disgusting. That's what it is.
Yeah, I don't. I can get past that, I guess.
I'm not going to look at chicken tenders the same ever again.
I just want her to love me as much as she loves dipping her chicken tenders in that soda.
She loved doing that, too. You can see the excitement on her face.
She was into it. I ain't never seen Danielle like that.
That was my opinion. The same thing.
Well, we could have gone without it.
We have a...
you brought nothing to the table. Mike's fucking relaxing back there in the Ford F-150.
Where's your other hand at? Let me see your hands. I'm worried about that right one. Or your left one. okay. Yeah. Yep. Fucking weirdo. So we have another officer shooting, but she wasn't on duty.
This don't make no goddamn sense to me.
Was that the one where she thought she walked in the wrong apartment?
She walked into the wrong apartment and was startled and shot the guy in his own apartment.
I saw like the. Oh, she killed him though, Micah.
Dude's dead.
She killed the guy in his own apartment because she thought she walked into hers and some dude was standing there in the living room.
Here's my thing. That would have never happened if he would have locked his fucking doors.
It was.
Exactly.
How did.
She didn't just walk in.
How'd she get in there?
She was fumbling and he heard her at the front door and he opened it.
Oh,
to be
I
like,
didn't
who
get that
the
far.
Fuck's at the front door?
I didn't
well,
read
his
that far.
Fault, too, for opening the door. She would have figured out that she was at the wrong house when. Yeah, no.
No.
Well, I guess you see an officer standing outside, too. You're going to open the door.
But she was off duty. She wasn't in uniform.
She was in duty. She just got off.
Oh.
Yeah. She just completed 10-hour shift. She just completed a 10-hour shift.
This whole story don't make no sense.
Yeah. Next.
Yep. But, yeah, she shot that motherfucker.
I did hear they're going to drug test her and alcohol test her to see if she was, like, drunk or whatever.
Impaired.
Yeah.
That's what I was like. Did she just get home from partying? They're like, no, she just got off shift. So, like, oh, they're going to blame it on fatigue. I'm like, we have come home blacked out drunk and still know where the fuck
I know
we
my house is my house.
Don't make no sense.
What'd she do? Have her pistol out already? Like, while she's fumbling the door key, and as soon as he opened it, bang.
She's wired up, man.
I think there was. My dad said she was also like 2014 or 17, maybe last year. She also shot another person, so they're investigating that too. Like,
well,
She's trigger happy.
She had a quick trigger.
Yeah.
Wasn't she a white lady?
Is that relevant?
Yeah.
Why?
That's what. That's
you
what
race
the,
baby? That,
yeah. That's what the news does.
You watch CNN, don't
the
you?
The news has it portrayed as a black man was shot by a white officer.
Of course they did.
Yeah.
That's the first
clickbait.
Thing they did.
Yeah.
But yeah, but I just had to go there. I was like, wanted to see if I could get one of y'all. Daniel, jump real quick.
Was he wearing a Nike shirt?
I don't have those details.
Yeah.
But
was she a white officer?
Her,
was he wearing a Nike shirt?
She took the shirt off and burned it after she shot. I'm not burning my Nike shit.
No.
I love the memes that are coming out.
Yep.
Freaking, yep. We got Jay Cutler.
Go ahead. Did you see the West Virginia Ninja meme?
Yep.
Yep.
What was it?
That one was good.
Something about your Judy's? Throw your Judy chops or something like that?
Just Judy it or just chop it.
They got a picture of Jay Cutler and it says, "Don't care, even if it means not caring about anything. Just do it or don't. I don't care."
Yeah.
It's like that's his personality too.
Oh yeah.
And then I got another one that's there's a dog and it's like bark at everything, even if there's something isn't there.
I saw one with Pete Carroll. It said sacrifice everything. Even if it means throwing the ball on the 1 yard line. or just run it.
Well, I had Stannis Baratheon. Believe in something, even if it means sacrificing everything, just do it. He ended up killing his own daughter.
Yeah, I saw one that said same thing, but instead, sacrifice everything, even if it means burning your daughter alive.
Yeah.
Who is this?
It's Game of Thrones.
Oh, fuck. Get out of here.
Yeah.
You get out of here.
She thought it was real. She was about to be like, "Who burned her daughter?"
She buried possums alive, so he burned her alive.
Yeah, she's still bitter about that shit. Her mom found a worm or a snake, and she sent a picture. And then she goes, "What do you think it is?" And Danielle goes, "Doesn't matter. You're gonna kill it."
Oh, I got a good one right here. It's Bruce or Caitlyn Jenner, whatever you wanna.
Yeah.
It says, believe in something, even if it means cutting your dick off.
No. That's hilarious.
Yep.
Oh, so what's up with this job shame?
Oh, yeah, I saw that. I guess an actor that used to be on, like, one of the stars in The Cosby Show. I guess acting jobs are hard to come by nowadays. So, a lot of actors and actresses, I guess, get real jobs, too, from time to time. And I guess someone saw him working at Trader Joe's, like, bagging and ringing out groceries. So they took a picture of him and posted it on social media, pretty much shaming him. Yeah, this actor, how the hell is this guy working at Trader Joe's now, this
yeah,
and
he shouldn't be working at Trader Joe's. He should be working at Publix.
Yeah, fuck Publix. But yeah, apparently he was job shamed and he ended up quitting his job at Trader Joe's because he was embarrassed and all that.
Yeah.
But I guess Tyler Perry.
Yeah.
I guess he got him a new job and all
that
stuff.
Yeah, but you know what show he's gonna be on?
No.
The Has and the Has Nots.
What's that?
That's the name of the show.
Oh,
so
he's a Has Not.
He's gonna put him on the Has Not. So you're gonna shame him even more. For like $24,000 or whatever he's getting paid.
Huh? It's more than what you get at the grocery store.
Hey, yeah. I'll take $24,000 to be on a show.
Yep.
I'll do that real quick.
Yeah, apparently he was shamed because they feel that he should be acting, even though it's hard to come by and to get jobs these days in acting. But they say, like, an actor, I was reading into it, they don't get paid a lot of money to be in the movies.
No.
Like, I saw, like, the lady that played Wonder Woman.
She's hot.
She got paid, like, $125,000 to play that part in that movie. But then they get the royalties and stuff off the movies and memorabilia and all that stuff.
If they would have got a bigger name actress, though, they'd be getting paid more.
Well, she's an A-list actor.
Good.
Yeah, she's an A-list now.
She is now.
Yeah.
I don't think she was when she did that, though. She's had a few things.
Yeah, but unless they're A-list, they don't get paid. They get paid a couple hundred thousand
like
to
do
Rock, that.
The Rock gets paid.
Oh, yeah, he gets paid millions per movie now.
Paid.
Yeah. Like Mark Wahlberg, people like that.
I wouldn't mind doing that. I just don't remember. I don't think I can remember the lines.
Like the Game of Thrones actors. Now they make like $5 million $20 million a season, something like that.
What were they getting season one though?
Yeah, nothing. Like the guy who played Robb Stark, people were like, "Oh yeah, that show made you rich." He was like, "Not when I was on it." He was like, "Not until the last few seasons did they start getting paid millions."
That sucks if you got killed off before it got big.
Yeah,
because you're not getting that. You don't have the following that it, or didn't when you were on.
People think actors and actresses make a shitload of money. They make compared to what we make.
Yeah, they make.
They do, but they're not what they don't make what you think they make.
And plus, most of the time, the standard of living or the cost of living wherever they're living at is a lot higher. So if they make a decent salary, but they're really not making.
But the Anthony Bourdain guy, when he died, they thought he was worth millions and millions. I think they said his worth, his net worth in money and property was like $2 million when he died.
That's crazy. You would think, like you said, you would think he would have a lot.
Yeah, they
more
thought he was closer to $20 million. No, he was like $2 million. Man.
Oh, yeah, I feel like I've been dying all morning.
I know, I've heard it all night. He was about 0.8 seconds away from vomiting in my truck again last night.
No, I think I was holding it, and I was a timing thing.
I had the window down when we left Paul and Wendy's. He goes, I don't think this window's helping roll it up. And I was like, it's helping me. It's staying down. And then as soon as we turn on Daughtry right here, we take a left off 98. It's when I hear the hoop. I'm like, oh, my God, get the fuck out of the truck. And he's like, hmm, the whole way. And as soon as he opened the door and we got in the driveway, so I went over there with the flashlight, make sure he didn't get all over my fucking side door and shit. And I'm like, what the
fuck? You saw when he was sitting there at the table. He was just like, hoop. The fucking then, hiccups were kicking
what
in.
What made me want to leave
it's
is Wendy's when
fault.
Started sweating at the table.
Oh, yeah, if I start sweating, yeah.
And I'm like, it's coming. We need to get the fuck out of here.
You left that whole drink on the table in the cup.
I was like, I just remember just getting up and leaving. I don't have any.
Yeah, you're like, what the fuck are we leaving?
Because you're sitting there dry heaving and sweating.
I would have thrown up and kept it moving. Yeah. And it probably would have been better if I would have done that because then I would have ate something.
You wouldn't have had it in your system this morning.
You
had a piece of chicken?
I had a little piece of chicken. Like, that was it.
We're making fun of you because you weren't eating the chicken. You were just, like, picking it apart. See, I'm eating chicken. I'm eating chicken. You're fucking picking that shit apart.
I had a whole bottle of Tito's last night to myself.
That's why you didn't go back to beer.
I should have had a little bit of Tito's and beer, but I went all Tito's. And
your last drink was Tito's, beer, and Gatorade all in one cup.
Oh, yeah, it was the orange Bud Light. But that was that was my first beer. That was my first beer that I drank.
And your last.
Because I ran out of Gatorade.
Terrible.
I need to pay attention to my drinks. I think I should.
We have this conversation every week. It's like rehab every single week.
Normally I'm good till Thursday. Well, now I'm good till the weekend.
And then Sunday, Jesus Christ hits them. I'm like, oh, maybe I should straighten my life up a little bit.
Nope.
I wasn't getting on. I wasn't trying to get on to myself about this, and I wasn't going to do this, but I was trying to use me to transition into the next topic.
You want to have an intervention on the podcast?
Yeah, I didn't realize. I didn't want to go this way. Yeah, I've been throwing up all morning, but
Mica heard you.
Oh, he's going to do it again.
Yeah, Mica heard you whenever we're getting the Skype connected and all that. You just hear,
oh, that was like the fifth time.
Like, damn, last week it was Danielle, and then this week it's John. Like,
mine was actual sickness, not due to liquor.
No, mine's part, I've been sick.
Yeah, okay, yeah, there we go.
Did y'all ever determine if Danielle's was morning sickness or she drank too much?
She took a pee test and she passed.
She studied and she passed.
I gave her a few punches to the gut.
We did MMA in the living room before she pissed on it. We grappled in the living room before.
Gave her a big bear hug.
John shoved her down the stairs, and they don't even have stairs. Yeah.
Yep. She wasn't even choking. He was giving her the Heimlich.
In the stomach area.
Oh, man.
Get out!
Yeah.
So where was your smooth transition going?
A South Carolina woman.
South Carolina.
Can't even talk with you fucks. She killed her husband by putting eye drops in his water for days.
I saw that. I instantly thought of you.
7 days.
She usually just gives him the shits.
Several days. So I guess he's been doing it for a while. Yeah. Cunt. I guess they when they did the autopsy, they found
autopsy.
Yeah. You know what I mean. Jesus Christ.
How'd that kill him? Did he?
Just too much. High amount of tetrodotoxin. She was charged with malicious tampering with a drug product or food. So.
Lots of cunts.
Oh, well, she was charged with that and murder.
Good.
Then I have a guy in Orange County, Florida, decided to shoot into a family's home after a negative restaurant review. So
what, was he the owner there or something?
I don't know if he was the owner or what. But basically, the guy said he was sitting on his couch and a bullet whizzed by his head.
All because of yelling.
Oh, shit.
Yep. And his daughter was in a room. Let's see where this goes. I guess the lady was disabled or whatever, possibly. And they told her that she couldn't go in there.
You gotta eat outside.
Yeah, eat outside or something like that. So she wrote a bad review. And that's when he decided that after that he was going to go shoot at their house. Because he found the review.
Terrible. That's why I don't review. That's why I don't do reviews.
I review all the damn time.
And they spit in your food. Good. Because that one bitch that came in and put that negative review on us.
I want to say, it was, it says on the Diner's Professional Facebook page, they posted a statement.
Not us.
I give good reviews, too.
I don't do no
reviews. I've never given a single review.
Just because I don't want no motherfuckers to do that shit, but yep. I guess the review was because of the discrimination. Like, she wasn't allowed in there or whatever.
What did she have?
I gotta read this thing. I'm a slow reader.
Apparently, like, broken legs or something if she's in a wheelchair.
Trying to read.
Was it not handicap accessible?
Probably.
That's great.
Yep.
I have bad news to report from my F-150.
Cell phone battery's dead?
10% left already.
Jeez.
We gotta speed this shit up. All right, next story, John.
Yeah, she was disabled.
We have time for you to read.
Regardless of whatever it was, she was disabled.
If I cut out, I'm not coming back.
All right.
I don't have a charger.
Well, what do you got? What do you got for whale facts?
Oh yeah, I found this awesome Twitter page that they post random facts about whales that you may or may not know.
Whales?
Whales.
Whales.
Whales. Whales.
Like you know the people that make a lot of money and they're called whales.
Huh?
You never heard of a whale?
No.
It's
I've heard of whale tails.
When the whales are somebody that walks into a casino or whatever, and they're the big time baller or whatever, and they, they have a lot of money. They call them whales.
Nope.
I call them rich.
Yeah. What movie was that? I seen that on a casino movie a while ago. I don't remember which one it was.
Anyways,
like their pinned tweet is whales are pretty fucking big. That's a whale fact.
No shit.
Yep. Whales are pretty fucking big. Most whales haven't seen The Godfather Part 2 yet. That's another fact.
Here's a fact from previous episodes. I'm pretty sure if a whale was to ejaculate, it'd probably fill up my house with sperm.
Yeah. That, we had a show named after that
40
one.
40 gallons.
Yeah.
40 gallons.
No, I thought it was 40,000 gallons.
40 gallons a day keeps us away. 40 gallons. Yep.
Oh, 40 gallons ain't going to fill the house up. Never mind.
A narwhal whale? It doesn't care if you think its tusk is impractical. It doesn't care.
What about its tusk?
It doesn't care if you think it's impractical.
It has tusk.
The narwhal whale, the one that has that one fucking horn on its head?
I don't remember seeing that.
Yeah, you seen that little
narwhals, narwhals, na 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 na. Stupid ass commercial.
Never heard that.
Yes, okay. You have.
You have.
Bullshit. No, I haven't. You guys are making shit up.
Do you know?
Here's another.
Go ahead.
Here's a whale fact. If a chicken tender falls into the ocean and the whale eats it, is that as fucked up as the lady dipping hers in coke?
Yes.
Why would that be fucked up, though, if a whale ate a chicken finger?
Because it'd be a soggy chicken finger.
And they don't know what chickens are, so why are they eating it? Here's another fun fact for you. Some whales will dive over a mile underwater just to get some goddamn peace and quiet. Yep.
I might be a borderline whale then.
Yeah.
Here at my undisclosed location, like, I would go to some extremes like that to get some peace and quiet.
Danielle would appreciate this one. A whale would never judge you for where you come from, but it definitely judged you for the amount of plastic you put in the ocean.
Oh, man.
I'll do one more. Let me see. Do-do-do. Whales will never break up with you on your birthday. And that's what we got for whale facts today on the Born Stupid Show.
Yeah, I was thinking, I was going to try to find a funny whale fact, but I didn't find
anything. What the fuck you say were wrong with my whale facts?
That was a whale of a time, guys.
Yeah. Oh, that was good. That's good. Killer whales can weigh up to 6 tons. I didn't know that.
Boring.
Oh. So, anybody draft Le'Veon Bell?
Nope, I'm smart.
Yeah, I didn't either.
Plus, he wasn't available when it was my turn.
I did pick up his backup, though.
James Conner.
Sarah Connor?
God damn.
Sinead O'Connor.
Sinead O'Connor? Sarah Connor's off the Terminator, yeah.
Yeah, I was like, Terminator.
Are you Sarah Connor?
I'm telling you, yes. James Conner will be the Terminator.
That's a narwhal.
Yep.
Okay, Hi,
I've
narwhal.
Seen that. Yep. I've seen that, but I don't remember the commercial you guys are fucking talking about. But yeah, so I saw this tweet that David Spade, I guess, drafted Le'Veon Bell, and he's like, hey, at Le'Veon Bell, I know this is a stressful time for you, but...
Go ahead.
I know this is a stressful time for you, but as I'm sure you've heard, I've drafted you.
Did David Spade do that in, like, his Joe Dirt voice, or...?
I've never seen that video. They play that on fucking commercials?
Yeah. Mike has no idea what's going on right now, because he can't hear it.
Okay.
I've never fucking seen that. What?
They didn't play that part on TV.
No, they just played the intro.
Yeah.
What the fuck's wrong with these things?
It was like a car insurance commercial or something like that.
Jesus Christ.
We're playing the Norwal song, Micah. You'll hear it when you play back the podcast.
Yeah. But they're talking about touching balls.
The only narwhal that I knew that was a whale was from Elf, when Buddy the Elf gets on the ice pad to go to New York.
Yeah. Right.
A big fucking whale pops up and goes, bye, Mr. Narwhal. Bye, buddy. I hope you find your dad.
I remember that. But I didn't know that. I thought that was his name. I didn't know that that's what they were called.
Stupid. Well, now you know what whale facts.
So back to David Spade. He drafted Le'Veon Bell. He said he knows it's a stressful time, blah, blah, blah. But I'm sure you've heard I've drafted you. So I can't have this right now. I need to get back in the game. I feel like this money convo can wait till January. I can float you whatever, but let's get on the field. Thanks.
It didn't help because he's still not there.
Yeah, he's still not there. But, I mean, I think he's a good running back.
I hope he don't come back all year. That way, everybody that picked him wasted a first-round pick.
Yep.
Because I didn't get him.
I just don't see why. I get you want to.
Isn't he the one that did some bullshit last year too?
Yep.
He sat out, and then he always hurts his hamstring, and then he gets suspended for smoking weed. And
he's been suspended twice. And there's a theory that the reason why he's holding out right now is because, in the NFL, once you sign, if you haven't been tested within 4 months, you're subject to a drug test. He's failed multiple drug tests, so if he fails this one, I don't know how long his suspension is.
Just get the Wizinator.
I doubt you can pass that way, though. Not now. They probably take blood. They probably do. I don't know what they do. But
he's only given up $829,000.
Not a big deal, right? Yeah, not a big deal. Actually, I think it was $855,000.
Oh, that's it?
$855,000. But, yeah, that was one of the theories, though, is he hasn't signed because he can't pass a drug test right now, and that's why he didn't tell anybody that he wasn't coming back, because he wasn't sure, you know, when he was going to do whatever. But whether that's the case or not, I mean, I don't know. But
lame.
I think James Conner is going to do good. And what was it, Jalen Samuels, the running back they picked up, he'll be pretty good this year, too.
Who?
He's back from NC State.
I don't know who that is.
Yeah. Well,
who
the fuck is that? Yeah. Everybody's gonna. They're gonna know who they are if they get a chance to ball out. If they don't, you know. Whatever.
This is me every time John talks about the Steelers.
Who the fuck is that guy?
Goddamn. Anyways, moving on. Would you guys get a tattoo of the Domino's logo for free pizza?
Goddamn right, I would. Yeah.
For life.
I'm one free sure. pizza, or pizza for life.
I'll do it for one free pizza. I don't care.
I want to say it's Domino's offers 100 free pizzas every year to anyone who gets a tattoo of their logo, and then but they ended up canceling the promotion because too many people were willing to get tattoos.
Yeah, I would.
But they were going to give you 100 pizzas during the year for getting a tattoo every year.
Damn.
Can it be one of them hyena tattoos?
No.
What?
Then Domino should step it up and be like, it's got to be a face tattoo.
Post Malone tattoo. Never tired.
Face tattoo?
You get the Domino right there on your fucking forehead.
Yeah. I was like, I would get a Domino's logo for free pizzas. I mean, if you got one, I got one.
Well, I'm paying $20 a month for a fucking little one to eat pizza every month. Yeah. Might as well get her a tattoo. Get it for free.
Yeah.
Tattoo?
It'll probably be based on the address. They wouldn't probably deliver multiple.
Should be based on the flesh, not the address.
Could you get all your 100 pizzas at the same time? Just get that one order.
Since you're buying a house, you could have your tattoo registered to this house.
Yeah.
She could have her tattoo registered to the new house.
Registered at daycare.
Yeah.
She's everybody. There more than here anyways.
Tattoo? But yeah, I would get a tattoo, but too bad they canceled the promotion because too many people were wanting to do it.
Bastards.
It's easy marketing, though. It's not free because they're going to have giveaway pizza.
I just need an excuse to get a tattoo. I haven't gotten tattoos in forever.
Yeah, I haven't either. It's been a couple years.
Too damn expensive.
Yep. Not worth the money. But yep. You guys got any work trolls? People that give you a hard time at work?
No, but I give people hard times at work. I'm that troll.
You're the troll?
Yep.
I troll sometimes, but I'm not normally a troll. You, Daniel, you got any trolls?
I got people.
She is the troll at work.
Jesus. We're not trolls, we're bitches. Anyways, so I was at lunch this week. I think it was Thursday. And there's Bucks and Eagles tickets that they're auctioning off, and I guess it comes with valet parking, and I guess the seats are pretty good. The value for the silent auction for these tickets is $375. So they have a sign-up sheet with the bid amounts. Well, I'm driving, or I'm getting ready to leave for lunch or come back to work, and coworkers said, "Good luck, John," and they sent me a picture. They wrote me down for $120. So I'm like rushing back to work trying to see like if this fucking paper actually has my name on it and if I can cross it out or when the auction ends, because I didn't know the date for the time that the auction was going to end because I didn't pay attention to the actual paper. But yeah, I was like rushing back to work just to see if they, and I was like fucking stressing it. I'm like, God damn, man, I don't have $120 right now.
That would suck though.
Yeah, but they were just pranking. They just basically took a copy of the original paper and then printed it out and then wrote my name down and then sent me a screenshot of a fake.
This is what I would have put.
$1,
Bob.
That's all I would have done for that. They started the bid amount at $100.
Oh, no thanks.
Yeah, I was like, nope. But yeah, it was funny. And they were all clocking in as I came back into work. So they all watched me walk up to the table to see if it's actually written down.
That's almost like when Danielle sends out a group text asking who wants to go to a game. And everyone's like, I will. All right, I just bought the tickets. We're like,
yeah, fuck.
We never discussed which tickets, what price.
What game?
Yeah.
I told you guys I had to be quick. And as soon as I got the yes, I was like, all right, they're in.
I'll have your money next weekend because that's when I get my ref check. Nice. So $150 of that. Skims right off the top to Danielle.
Bye-bye.
I'm like, they didn't have like $69.99 tickets.
No, that was the cheapest.
And Micah, don't you
have I'm not even a fan of either team. And I spent $150 on the ticket for the game.
You're going to go tailgate and get drunk.
Yeah.
We're going to have a great time.
Yep.
And I took the next day off, too.
So, Micah,
shout-outs. Don't you got some house-shitting stories? Or people recognize you from shitting on houses?
We got some fan mail for the Born Stupid show, and I figured out how people identify me with the show.
You're the pooper.
It's not because it's not because of my vocal talent or
your quick wit.
His stunning looks.
My stunning looks. They identify me as the shitter. Claire's mom, she was FaceTiming her back and forth, and she's like, "Hey, it's Mike over there." She's like, "Well, who's that guy?" Uh-oh.
Oh, he's using power.
I about lost battery. Holy shit.
Speed it up.
Anyway, so I was talking to her, and she's like, "Oh, I know who you are. You're the shitter on the Born Stupid show." That's me. Guilty as charged. And then Ross's sister and sister-in-law were like sending shout-outs or whatever. I see we were fans before the Born Stupid show, this, that, and the other. And then Ross's sister chimes in and goes, I was listening to the episode where you shit on John's house. I literally laughed out loud. That's how you guys identify me?
The pooper.
Oh, man.
What? Like, what has my life come to? Like, that's my biggest achievement in life.
Shitting on my house. That's why we're moving, is because of you, bitch.
Yeah.
The flies have been unreal since you've done that.
It sounds like you threw up in the same spot last night. So.
I was pretty damn close.
Because you smelt the shit.
Yeah, I smelt the shit. That's what triggered it. Told her to roll the fucking windows up.
PTSD kicked in.
I was fertilizing your plants because you never water them, and then you had to wash shit down. So I did your plant a favor.
That's a classic. That's a great story. Like, sorry you had to suffer through it, but it was a great story.
That's up there with me shitting in the flower pot at the Civic Center and puking on my brother's back porch.
I was going to say, they don't identify Ross as the shitter. He shit in a freaking flower pot in public in front of people, a whole parade of people.
That's what they get for not having Porter Johns.
That's terrible.
But he gets no attention for that.
Nope. I was a minor back then, so.
Yeah, no respect, man. No respect around here.
I was a grown-ass man.
Getting charged with
shit my pants.
Indecent exposure.
And now we all know not to get the buffalo wings at the bowling alley.
Yeah.
Speaking of being a grown-ass man, I had a Will Ferrell from Old School moment yesterday. I came all the way back to my undisclosed location for work, supposedly. Well, my day consisted of going to a Hobby Lobby.
Oh, that's cool. They're expensive.
Yep. Went to a Hobby Lobby.
Hey, quick question.
There, went to...
Is it the same as here? Like, has it got the same stuff?
Yes.
Yeah, it's the same shit.
Well, you know, because certain same states shit. Have they cater to their state and their demographics, so I wanted to know if it's about the same stuff.
It's the same shit, overpriced, made in China stuff. Yeah.
Okay.
So we got down to the Hobby Lobby, and they're like, oh, yeah, let's go over here to the Menards Home Improvement Store and pick out some tile flooring. I'm like, sweet. So we walk around there. It's like a Lowe's, but a Home Depot, but better. We get done there. And they're like, what else should we do? So
get the fucking work so I can go home.
We go to Art Van Furniture and look at outdoor patio sets and couches and shit. And at that point, I'm sitting there at the Art Van Furniture, walk around like, my God, that's what my Saturdays have come to. Like, old people shit. Like, you walk around and look at stuff. Like,
you're not even trying to buy it. You're just walking around looking, just checking out what they got.
Used to, Saturdays was like pool parties and drinking and tailgates and, man, college football's on, we're barbecuing. And now it's come to this shit, and I'm like,
now you're trying to get now you're trying to get the early bird special at Golden Corral.
Oh shit, like, what am I doing with my life, man?
You're hanging out with old people.
You're being responsible, that's what you're doing.
After this, I plan on going to watch the Steeler game and drinking some more.
No, you're not.
That's what I'm doing.
Meaning, I'm going to go to my dad's house, watch the Steeler game, and puke some more.
I'm going to go puke in his pool.
Yeah.
He's not home. He's at the beach this week, and I was like, hey, is it cool if I come over and watch the Steeler game if it's not on the local channels?
It's not, because the damn Bucks are on. Oh, man.
Watch him beat up the Browns today.
Yeah.
You'd be surprised.
I hope they don't lose today. I'd be pissed. Both my teams went down. The fucking Gators. I didn't even get to watch the game last night because I was so drunk. And then I wake up this morning and find out they lose.
Florida State almost lost to Samford.
Who?
Samford. Not Stanford. Yeah. Sam, like, and Sam Bradford. Sam Ford. Samford.
That coach is going to get gone.
Yep.
They're going to let him go.
I watched the opening quarter of the FSU Virginia Tech game on Monday.
I watched a little bit of that one, yeah.
And I knew right damn well, before the opening kickoff, all the FSU players are all dancing, freaking hoop-hauling around. The sidelines are all dancing. They kicked the ball off of Virginia Tech, and quiet old Virginia Tech ran the ball straight down their fucking throat down the middle of the field and scored a touchdown.
Yeah.
Touchdown.
Yeah, you guys are out there dancing, acting like a fucking bunch of idiots. And here's quiet old Virginia Tech. All right, kick us the ball, and then we're going to pound the ball down your fucking throat.
They couldn't stop them.
No, and they beat FSU's ass.
I enjoyed watching Florida State and Miami getting dominated.
That's typical Florida State. They're one of those teams where we're FSU, we're big and bad, and then they suck half the time.
Yep, I was disappointed when I woke up and saw the Florida loss, though. They lost to fucking Kentucky. That's like the first time in how many years?
They beat Kentucky 31 years in a row.
And it's all my fault. If I wouldn't have drank that whole bottle and I'd have been watching, they would have won.
Yeah, they lost because I was there.
Yeah, you fucking...
Yeah, I'm the kiss of death. Every time I'm there when the Gators play, they lose.
It's fucking shitty. It's true, though.
I'll go ahead and go out on a limb and say John's going to be throwing up in the morning when the Steelers lose to the sorry-ass Browns.
And Sarah Connor blows out her knee.
I don't think Sarah Connor's going to do
that. Shanae O'Connor bumps the ball first play.
I think Shanae O'Connor is going to ball out today. She's going to rush for about, I would say, close to 100 yards, maybe over 100 yards. And I would go with my prediction as far as receiving. He's going to have over 50 yards receiving. So, total, probably around 200 total yards. That's my prediction for
it's
him.
Fake news.
Just saying.
They're going to lose 21-24.
Boom.
And they're gonna lose on a botched field goal attempt by Boswell.
Don't you fucking
He's
say gonna
that. He's going to shank it left like
don't
fucking
you,
Ray Finkel.
Don't you fucking even go there. Who the Patriots play today?
The fucking Texans, man. Texans? I think the Patriots are going to lose.
Texans
are no joke.
Fucking scary team this year.
Yep. Or one of the best defenses, and they have freaking Sean Watson.
That's a scary team. I think they're going to be pretty damn good.
Yep.
They had I also saw there was some talk about Dez Bryant.
Nothing but football talk left?
No, not really. We're just kind of BSing. No.
Yeah, Micah's running out of battery, so we'll be wrapping up here in a second.
Yeah, we're going
to
be done.
I'm down to like 2%.
All right, so that gives us 3 minutes. Because he was at 10 minutes or 10% 7 minutes ago.
Yeah, you're pretty good at math. Oh, man.
Yeah, so I guess we'll wrap it up.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's been a good show.
Enjoy the first week of NFL Sunday.
I can't wait.
Yeah. The fucking Falcons-Eagles game was a barn burner.
Yeah.
I heard both those teams sucked.
They both sucked. The offenses were terrible.
I think you'll see a lot of that this first week. A lot of shitty play.
Rusty.
A lot of people set out during preseason. So.
Yep. Yep. Alrighty.
Yep.
Okay.
So we'll see y'all later.
See you later, man.
See you, Micah.
See you guys.
Thanks
you
for
guys.
Listening, everybody. Appreciate it.
Yep. Catch us up on all of our apps: Podbean, Yahoo, or not Yahoo, fucking Yahoo, YouTube, Facebook. All of the above.
I still use Yahoo.
Yeah.
Spotify,
Podbean, RSN Podbean, Google.
Google Play.
All right. We'll see y'all next week.
Thanks, guys.